So I wasn't here yesterday for science. So can someone raise their hand and tell me what you guys did and learned about yesterday? Sadie. Give me the start of it so someone else can tell me more.
So I have it in my head.
Okay, that's all right. Can we help her out?
So we watched a video on the meteor that hit Earth.
Uh-huh.
And we learned about how we're learning about the energy and how it travels through different objects.
How the energy travels through different objects. Do you want to add something to that, Eric?
We watched a video about the meteor crashing on Earth and that, like, how did it get its energy? How was it, like, so it's like it can't be created or something like that.
Can you say that again? Energy can't be what?
Created or destroyed.
So what is it? If it's not created or destroyed, then it's
eternal.
Olivia?
It's already there.
It's already there. Did you want to ask something, Brock?
And in the video, it said that how the asteroids are created and how the energy from whenever the asteroid gets its energy whenever it hits a planet.
Mm-hmm.
And when the asteroids hit it, and whenever all like that planet became the asteroids, it was like talking about how it got its energy from that planet.
Okay, how the energy transferred, is that what you're saying? Awesome. Okay, now today we're going to get to see some more about how energy is transferred. But first, I want everyone to open up your iPad, go into Padlet, and we're going to be reading a short article together. So under our resources, we have our basketball story. So I'll give you a moment to get there. Open up our basketball story. Okay, why do basketballs bounce? Can I ask someone who can start off our reading for us? Riley, read us our first paragraph. So everyone's going to follow along on there.
There are 20 seconds left in the clock, and you just stole the basketball from the other team. You're making a fast break down the court. The basketball is bouncing on the court as you dribble it to the other end. All of a sudden, you ask yourself, why do we use basketballs to play basketball?
Okay. Luke, will you read our next paragraph?
Basketballs and similar balls have abilities to dunk. Not all things can dunk very well. Rocks and other hard things do not bounce well. They crack or make loud noises when they hit the surface.
Awesome. Sarah Case.
Why do basketballs bounce? It has to do with energy. When you pick up a basketball, you use energy. The basketball then has chemical energy, which means it has the potential to do something. When you drop the basketball, the potential energy changes to kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy of motion.
Awesome. Lauren, will you read us that last paragraph?
The one that says
a rock is different. Awesome. Thank you to everyone who read. We're going to talk about that in just a second, but first I want us to watch this really cool slow motion video. So this is kind of what it was talking about and what we just read. Now we're going to get to watch it. It's only like 15 seconds, so it's super short, so make sure you're watching.
What is it?
slow motion to see how that energy is transferred. They bounced it outside on the ground, and there was just some dirt that was out there. Yes, Brock, thank you for raising your hand.
Why do things just say, how cool is the ball whenever you bounce the ball, you can't see it, whatever, like the slow motion of the Thomas the Train ball, how come you, like, it splashed down and then, like, hit it on the like, it all got flat instead. Whenever you bounce the ball, and nothing happens, it's just like a normal ball just bouncing.
So that was bouncing in the video, just slow motion. So it went down, and it went back up. But so that asked, who can answer our question? Why did that ball bounce?
But how come? Also, and what was that? Whenever the ball hit that white thing, and then whenever you could like see mist going around.
That's a good question, but we're going to hold on. I'll come back to that, okay? First, let's answer this first question. Why did the basketball or that ball in that video bounce? Sarah Kate.
Because it wasn't hard.
I like that you said how it wasn't hard. It was soft. So we could also say it was flexible. So what if something that was less flexible hit the floor? What would happen? What would happen if the basketballs are flexible? Harrison, what do you think something less flexible hit the ground?
It would either crack or make a loud noise.
Just like we read, it could make a loud noise, it would crack. But why? Anyone have any other ideas on that? Andrew.
It's probably too hard. Imagine
if I dropped
the iPad on the ground, it wouldn't bounce, it would just like make a loud noise or crack.
Exactly. Yes, Brock.
I know why it bounced. Because it was kinetic energy.
Kinetic energy. Okay, yeah, it had the potential energy going down.
And then whenever it hit the ground, the kinetic energy went into the potential energy, and then the kinetic energy went in, but whenever it bounced back up, the kinetic energy left, and then the potential energy came back in.
You hit that right on the nail, Brock. Yes, did you want to add something? That wouldn't bounce, right? Awesome. I like how you made that connection, some background knowledge you have. Now what we're going to do, I know you have some more ideas and we'll get to talk about it more. I want everyone to take out your science notebook. And if I can get my paper control to hand everyone scissors and glue, please. But for right now, I want you to go to your table of contents and we're going to add our next title. No, not for right now. Right now we're just writing something down. So you can go ahead and lock your iPad on your desk while we're writing in our journal.
Yes.
That would depend what the rock is made of, though, right? If it's something can hold that potential energy. But most rocks that are not flexible, then it would just crack. Yes, so let me write it up here. Can I get... When you're done, when you finish handing it out, put your glue. So today's date is October 3rd. We're going to title it Let's Bounce. And we should be on page 12. So once you fill it out in your table of contents, you can flip to that next clean page in your journal. Start writing that and cutting and pasting. If you haven't gotten in your table yet, I'm going to come around. Yes, you may, after you cut and paste, you may throw your trash in the trash can and come back and take a seat. Behaviors when we're working in these groups with all these different materials. What's something that we should be doing while we're in these groups, Tim? Using items appropriately, for sure. There's a lot of items we have, and I'm telling you exactly what you should be doing with them. Melody. Exactly. That's a very good point. Don't snatch it away from them. So, like I said, we're gonna have groups of four. But if you notice, there's only three balls that we're gonna be bouncing. That means one person is not going to get to bounce a ball. That means we have one person who's the recorder, one person who's the golf ball, one person who's the softball, and one person who's the basketball. So that's going to be very important. I like that. Luke.
So when we do this, since there's, what do you mean by there's only, well, there's six bins,
mm-hmm.
will there be like one, two, three, two?
will have four people in their group, but one person will have five people in their group. So we'll check that. Okay, let's go back to our most desirable behaviors quiz, because this is going to be crazy with all the things that we have going on. Yes, Anna?
Use your partner voice.
So even though we're working in groups of four, we're still called our partner voice. Yes, it's very good. Riley?
Can we have our groups or in your group?
I'm going to tell you who's in your group. Sarah Beth? Yes, Timma, I think it was Timma or Anna that actually said that one, but it's true, use them appropriately. Yes, Katie.
Same one spot.
So we have our desk arranged like this. So in our, when you have your pairs of desks, I don't want, a group is gonna pick one pair of desks. So there shouldn't be two groups at one desk grouping. So if I'm here with my group, the next group needs to find somewhere else to go, okay? Okay, so I'm gonna write on here a reminder of directions. Does anyone have there? Okay, I'm gonna have Lauren. Will you read us our first bullet in our directions, what it says there? Okay, can I get someone to read that next bullet of our directions? Anna. Okay, so we don't have rulers in our bin, but that's going to be about just taller than the length of your notebook. So I don't want you dropping the basketball on your desk from all the way above your head. Just hold up your notebook and a little bit above it. Okay? All right, for the third bullet, Luke, will you read that to me?
So I have a question. Will we be doing this on Post or Caesar?
We'll do it on Padlet.
Okay.
Okay, can I get someone with the third bullet, Katie?
Record what happens to your items on the table in your data table.
Okay, awesome. So, like, in your data table, just like we do every week, we record our observations so that way we can use the data to make conclusions later. So as you're dropping these balls, I want you to, you're gonna bring your pencil and write down what you see. And if you don't finish, we'll have some extra time to work on it again. But so in each of those boxes are gonna be filled out by the end of it. Okay, now for our fourth bullet, Jaden, will you read it to us? All right, thank you. And our next one, Weston. Okay, so you're gonna do it three times. That means that each ball is gonna be dropped from your distance three times. And I'm writing, I know some people cut off those directions off the top. So I'm summarizing up here what you need to do. Okay, and I'm going to write up here, too, what I want you to name your Padlet post. So let's get started with it. So I want you to bring, the first person's name I say is going to bring their iPad, but everyone else in the group just needs their notebook and their pencil to record. Okay, so for our first group, we're just going to go Riley, Cooper, Jaden, and Rush. So Riley, bring the iPad. You guys can go back and grab a bin and a basketball, and choose your one of your tables. And can I get Sadie, Liam, Yuna, and Luke? So Sadie, bring your iPad. Go get a bin and grab a basketball from the black bag. Can I get Timma, Jeffrey, Ashton, and Anna? Can I get Harrison, Sarah Kate, Brock, and Lauren to grab a bin and a basketball? Good, awesome. So use that ruler to measure 12 inches. Just wait a moment till you get started, though, please, so all of our groups have their places. Can I do Weston, Stephanie, the same page. If you have a question, you can raise your hand. So right now, I want you to be laying out your materials after I'm speaking. Then, I didn't tell you guys which ball I want you to record. That's my fault. Okay, I'm going to tell you now, so that way you can know. So I'm going to tell you which, this is the ball I want you to do first. So if you're in Sadie's group, not yet, after I'm finished, I want you to do the basketball first and record it and put it on the tablet. Okay, we'll get you one in a second. Then you guys can do the softball first, okay? If you are in Tim's group, we're going to do the basketball first. So go ahead and put a star by basketball. Sadie's group, go ahead and put a star by softball. If you are in Brock's group, I want you to do the basketball first. Put a star by basketball. If you're in Riley's group, do the golf ball first. Go ahead. Everyone put a star by golf ball. If you're in Zay's group, I want you to do the softball first. And if you're in Haley's group, you can do the golf ball first. Only recording one time. So if this group right here is the basketball group, then Harrison's going to hold the basketball while all the materials are laid out on the desk. Someone else is going to record. You make that one post, and now you're done with Padlet. Then you keep going through the golf ball and the softball, and you're going to write that information down on your table, but you only are making one post. So you can put everyone's name in your post for your group. So when Sadie's group posts, it's going to say Sadie, Luke, Yuna, Liam, and they're going to put which ball they drop, and they're going to post that one video. And now they're done with Padlet, and they keep going through and making their observations. Yes, Rob.
We do
you're observing, after you lay out all the materials on your desk, you're observing how dropping this ball is affecting those other objects. So before we get started, I want you to have a cleared off space. Everyone pick wherever you're at, make sure it's a clear area. Put the pinto beans spread out across it. Put the rock on that cleared space. So take the pinto beans out of the bag. This doesn't require talking. Please just look in your box. Take out your pinto beans. If you're missing something, you can raise your hand. Started. And this group looks about
Thank you.
the coach and erase it for me so he can come out. Let's see if we're going to drop this basketball on the table. Let's see how all this energy is transferred. Thank you. finishing up your ball droppings and your observations. You can put your materials away.
Softball.
You don't want to watch them?
No, let's do it.
stations in the basketball area filled out. Now we can have our science notebook open and let's talk about what happened when we dropped the basketball. What did you notice, Sadie?
All of the beans moved.
Jaden, what did you notice with the basketball dropping?
All of the beans bounced.
The beans kind of bounced?
And they moved.
But you didn't drop the basketball on the beans, so why were the beans moving? Brock? Why did the desk shake?
The desk shook because whenever the potential energy from the basketball, whenever it hit the kinetic energy from the basketball hit the desk and then it traveled through all the way to the beans and then that's what made the beans bounce.
So Brock was saying it went from the ball and hit the table and then energy was transferred there from all the materials. That's exactly right. That's awesome. Let's talk about what about for the softball? How did that affect the tape? Or excuse me, how did that affect the objects compared to the basketball? So my question's a little different. Compared to the basketball, how did it change when we use the softball? Sarah Kate. Two, if they move more with the golf ball. So one, if the objects move more with the basketball, or two, if the objects move more with the golf ball. What do you think? When you drop the basketball or the golf ball, what made the objects move more? So one, basketball, two, golf ball. Okay, I see a couple different ones. So I guess it could depend. What could make us have different answers, Stephanie? Why would some people have a different answer?
Got it.
And so, like, Yeah, so people could have thrown it at different strengths, kind of like when we did our experiments on Monday. Depends how hard or soft that you throw, that how much energy is transferred and it affects. So tomorrow in science, we're going to be talking about which one transferred the least amount of energy. We're just talking about the most, and tomorrow we'll be talking about which one transferred the least, so we can be thinking about that. Yes, Harrison? So typically a basketball would make your objects move more, but you could have had a different answer. Take one more hand, and then that's all we have for science, Anna.
So they could have, like, the basketball, it might not be exactly, it could have been at, like, lower or higher.
That's a very good point. Right, so we were supposed to hold it right above the top of the ruler, but some people might have not been paying close attention. Okay, my friends, that's all we have for science, so I want you to close your notebooks.